performance measuring is quite complex, also for primary care, but for healthcare systems in general. What we use is a kind of a analytical framework where we say the structure of primary care is important, like for instance the policies, the governance, the processes are important in terms of people's access, the continuity of care, coordination of care, and the comprehensiveness of care, having all the different parts of primary care in one system. And then you look at the outcomes of care, first in terms of the quality of the processes, the quality of care, but also the efficiency, is it working well, and equity, which is very important, of course, the differences between, for instance, socioeconomic or ethnic groups should be as small as possible and only depend on people's need. And in the end, performance is depending on a good or bad performance, depends on whether there is indeed an effect on population health. I tend to see it as the alchemist of the Middle Ages who was trying to find gold, and I think we take probably 2 spoons of evidence and 6 other spoons, and they're partly ideology, political ideology, anticipation to the next coalition, the changeability of the system. If you have a centralized state-dominated system, it's easier to make changes. The influence is also a spoon in this alchemist's recipe, a spoon of probably pressure groups, professional interests. So yes, evidence plays a role, but we should be aware that it's not the only thing. We're looking at the quality of primary care in a comparative view of the European, of the member states of the European Union and a bit broader countries around that. We are looking at the quality of the healthcare processes, and we are trying to connect that to health outcomes. So we're looking at whether the healthcare system has an influence, how the primary care system is organized has an influence on equity of care. The first big challenge is in self-management and support for self-management in chronic disease and in multimorbidity. I think that's really a challenge, probably for the whole of healthcare, but the first layer of healthcare that's confronted with this is, of course, primary care. And it's not only self-management in the sense that people have learned to manage their own disease, but healthcare providers have to learn to support people in living with their disease. So that's my first big challenge. The second one is more in the organization of care. I think there's a big challenge in trying to tune the different parts of the systems into a productive system, like that the relationships between primary care and hospital care should be very They should be good in terms of being able to refer patients, but also to get the patients back again, to be able to trust secondary care that they're not doing all kinds of useless interventions with patients. So the relationship between primary care and secondary care is important, but as important are the relationship with public health and community services in terms of social care. And I think with an aging population, multimorbidity population, and in a time of financial crisis, these social sector and public health relationships are very important. So that's my second big challenge, tuning the different parts of the system. And the third one is probably how to integrate prevention in day-to-day primary care. Prevention is important, we all know that, but so often the relevant population is not reached. The say the well-to-do highly educated people find more or less their own prevention. But it's especially the population groups that are the most difficult to reach that need it most. And a strong primary care system, which is population-oriented, community-oriented, could make a difference in that area.